I know that a lot of SEOs hate JavaScript.
Right.
And right. I get why. It's very complex. It makes our lives difficult. It makes developers' lives difficult. Mm-hmm. Right. But I feel like this is a good time to talk about a very good news for them.
What's that?
And the good news for them is that JavaScript SEO is dying. It has an expiration date of some sorts. I guess we all know that. Okay. Like, think about that for a second. Like, if Google starts rendering JavaScript on scale, what's going to happen to JavaScript SEO?
But I mean, is it going to die, or is it going to simply evolve?
It's going to the farm, I guess.
The farm upstate.
Farm upstate.
You mean with my dog?
Yeah, just where your dog went. Yeah. Darkness, my old
friend. All right, so. Is search engine inability to deal with JavaScript, is that what JavaScript SEO is based on?
Yeah.
Fundamentally?
Yeah. Like 100%. Like, I guess if there were no search engines, there wouldn't be JavaScript SEO.
Okay.
We only do that, like developers, when they build a website they're excited about. So you build like Nike.com.
Okay.
They check if that works properly in the browser, some of their tools, and that's it. If it works for all of their users, they're good to go. Our job is like adding an extra layer for them. So developers, I'm guessing they don't love JavaScript SEO that much because they need to do a lot of extra steps just for search engines. So once search engines are as good with JavaScript, JavaScript is very expensive, so it's difficult. Once search engines are as good as, let's say, Chrome on your iPhone, we're done here.
All right, now, but in recent weeks, Google has made some significant steps in this area. What do they have to do, though, to kind of, to close the deal?
Crawling JavaScript is expensive. It's so expensive. Let's say, this is, I don't have anything to compare straight. Indexing HTML is that much. Indexing JavaScript is sometimes this wall. It's just massively expensive, complex, and big, and whatever. Probably terrible comparison.
That was awful.
Awful.
Okay, so in recent weeks, Google has made significant advances in this subject. But what else do they have to do to kind of close this deal?
That's a complex topic, and we already established that there is no comparing that to anything, especially my hand. So Google has to invest a lot of money into rendering JavaScript. A lot of money. So that's why I'm guessing they're either building the infrastructure for that or and probably literally building the server buildings or whatever, or they're looking for a cheaper way to do that, more efficient way to do that.
All right, but we're always kind of focusing on Google, but what about other search engines like Bing or Yandex?
So for them, the cost, because they don't have this many users, the cost is exponentially bigger. So I'm guessing once Google is going to start rendering JavaScript, they need to regroup, rethink, maybe, I don't know. They're going to be in a lot of trouble.
Really? But so, which means is that if a user who's using Bing and they don't know anything else and they're just using Bing, they're kind of locked into a very different kind of search reality than they would be if they were on Google.
Yeah. So they won't find a lot of JavaScript websites. So as of today, they wouldn't find angular.io. So if you're a developer and for some reason you're using Bing, you won't find the website of the framework of JavaScript you're using, and that's probably enough for you to switch to Google. And this example will multiply, obviously.
Alright, so the death of JavaScript SEO is obviously down the road. What should people or SEOs be focusing on right now?
So we need to. First of all, it's not going to happen overnight. So we still have quite a lot of time. And only even us here at Onely, I'm guessing we were one of the first agencies who ever started with JavaScript. Even for us, it's not going to be that much of a deal. We're ready for that for a while. But it's going to evolve into something. So once there is JavaScript, once JavaScript SEO is gone, we're probably going to have to deal with things like JavaScript crawling budget. And then we can guess, even if it's gone completely, it's going to make your, so like I'm guessing user, developer, website owner life much easier. Mm-hmm. So I wouldn't worry for that. There's always too much work with technical SEO anyways.
Okay. And beyond JavaScript SEO, what do you think is going to be the next big thing?
I'm guessing that web performance is on the rise, and there are a lot of new trends with how we use mobile to like interfere with the website. So I'm guessing it's going to steer in that direction, mm-hmm. but I don't have any clear theories yet.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you very much, Christian.